racing mode. How do you find it? And how can you play? In the recent War Thunder update, we added a new gaming mode, Air Racing. From time to time, we will be including racing missions in the events panel, as we have recently done already. Races give you silver lions and research points. The higher you position at the end of the race, the bigger the reward you will get. Tell us about the changes in arcade tank battles. In War Thunder 143, we have significantly changed tank arcade battles. Now every player getting a particular number of frags can initiate a mini event. It's a short flight in attacker aircraft or bombers, or a flight in a fighter to support your teammates in the air and intercept the enemy planes. To fly each kind of aircraft, you have to score the appropriate number of tank frags. One frag to fly as a fighter, two frags to fly as an attacker, and three frags to fly as a bomber. These mini events are available for less than a minute, but skillful players are able to score against several enemy ground targets in one flight. We have also changed the artillery support logic in Tank Arcade. Now one artillery strike can be obtained for one frag or capturing the strategic point. You are able to accumulate up to three artillery strikes and use them one after another. Every player has an ability to use one artillery strike after some time spent in the battle. What's new in tank battles in realistic mode? Every player will have some respawn points at the beginning of every battle that can be spent on choosing one ground vehicle in a player's setup. Destruction of enemies, hitting the enemies, capturing points, and received damage grants new respawn points to a player. These respawn points can be spent on choosing new ground vehicle or aircraft after the player's death. Every respawn doubles the number of respawn points required to choose a new vehicle. Thus, we have limited number of respawns in realistic battles. So, you are able to play both ground and aerial vehicles in RB mode in War Thunder. Automatic consolidation into squads with random players. How does it work? Playing together is fun, so in our recent update, we have added automatic consolidation into squads with other players for players who play without a squad. Playing in a squad gives you the opportunity to score special squad achievements. If you don't want to play in random squads, you may disable this option in the game options. How do I see internal modules in my tank? You may enable the option to show your armor and the internal modules of your tank in the hangar, in the tank description card, or the customization tab. Also, you are able to see the condition of internal modules in a battle. To do this, you have to designate a hotkey in the controls options. What is the difference between minimal and full client of the game? The minimal client has been created as a trial. It is a light version of War Thunder for newcomers and for those players who do not use all War Thunder features. In minimal client, there are no cockpit views or simulator mode. The high-quality textures are disabled. There are no custom battles, single missions or decals, and some music tracks are not available. Thus, we managed to reduce the minimal client size to a bit more than 3 gigabytes. Those players who have tried the minimal client and want to see the game in all its goodness, we recommend that you download the full client. To do this, just check the checkbox in the launcher. How do you increase the download speed of updates? In Update 143, we have significantly improved the launcher for War Thunder, also optimizing the download speed for our players. Unfortunately, some players still experience problems when downloading the client. There may be multiple reasons for this, but most of them can be solved only on your provider's side. To solve the most widespread problems, we recommend that you turn off the UTP option in launcher settings. Why is visibility in realistic battles limited to 6 kilometers? We really hope to reduce the amount of players that in all situations start climbing at the beginning of a battle. This is boring, and we believe that it significantly limits the possible complexity of the fights. So, we put the players in a situation where they see enemy markers only at 6 kilometers distance, which means that the reaction toward the battle situation will be more dynamic and will probably bring new tactics and diversity to the gameplay. Why do bombers have their wings ripped off more often recently? We have changed the materials of the airframe so that they are historically correct. Now, when performing aggressive maneuvers, all aircraft, not only bombers, that couldn't handle the G-loads due to their construction, will be damaged. Bombers were mostly flying in level flight. We do not ask you to only fly straight, but bear in mind that a bomber is a heavy machine, and even insignificant loads, by some points of view, are huge for the aircraft's airframe. So, be prepared that wings may be ripped off. Join our Facebook group, subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Twitter. See you soon in War Thunder.